Aky Karim for British Boxers, and we're joined by the WBO lightweight. In fact, we're not joined. We're actually at his house here in the surroundings, and we're just here to basically, we've got a lot to talk about. Firstly, just defended your WBO lightweight title against Petr Petrov.
Yeah.
What did you make of Petrov? He turned out to be tougher than a lot of people thought he would be.
He was as tough as he expected. Me and Steve sat down. Everything that he'd done on the night, Steve told me he was going to do. Didn't do nothing what we didn't expect. And yeah, it ended up a comfortable win, really.
Yeah. Now, it was a comfortable win, but a lot of the times at the end of rounds, you look quite frustrated going back to Steve in the corner. You sort of like, you were giving off the impression that you weren't happy with your work and that.
No, I knew Steve wasn't happy, so I was just showing him that, yeah, I sort out next round, and he's like, never mind that, just do it. Stop moaning and shaking your head, just do what I'm asking you to do, go in your boxing and you'll get him out of there. And yeah, I did it in parts, but I didn't keep it going for long enough. But yeah, to Serbia, mandatory challenger on Bell, who's in a round, a tough guy.
Yeah,
I'm happy with that.
Technically as well, when you were on sort of like long range and mid range, you were looking properly sharp and you were taking him apart. Obviously, he spoiled a lot and he tried to get it close range. What did you make of that?
Yeah, I knew he lunges in from far, and when he was coming, so although I stepped my feet back and landed a few times, he'd fall through it, and he had to be careful with his head. So then I'll get caught without out of silly, really, because he's a swinger as well. And yeah, just coasted to comfortable points, weren't we?
Yeah, yeah. And a word on the crowd and the support in Manchester. I mean, I've been to your last five or six fights at least, and that seemed to be your best sort of reception as well. Was it good to be at home and getting that reception?
Yeah, it's great because now BT are on board, a lot more people are knowing who I am and starting to come out, and bigger platform, and you can see it feels bigger and getting a lot more people interested, more people can see it. And yeah, I'm happy with the way it's going now. I mean, it's only going to get bigger and better.
Exactly, yeah. And what did you make of the undercard as well? Good undercard, a lot of Manchester prospects on there as well.
Yeah, it was a good undercard. The fight Williams and Smith, that was a bit controversial, ended, and that'll probably get made again. Yeah, what else? Nicole Adams on Nicole the bill.
Daniel Dubois. That.
Yeah, Jack Catchell, Geffen. There's some great fights, and yeah, some 50-50 fights. And me and Petrov was seen to be a 50-50 fight, and I made easy work of it. So
yeah
it's.
You don't get the easy fights, do you? In a way, like the easy defenses and that. You tend to get put in with guys who make other fighters look bad, don't you? For people like Fana, people like, you know.
Yeah, I mean, this was a fight where I thought I might have got more boxing off. I did in parts, but like keeping it going, and I'd not been doing it enough. So yeah, just had to build on that one, really.
Yeah. Now in the press conference afterwards, you know, one of the names that kept coming up was Linares.
Yeah.
Obviously, he's just done. He's just looked really good in his last fight out with Anthony Crawler. Is that the name then that you really want?
That's who I want. Yeah, I want a unifying, especially after this performance against Crawler. It shows that he is world class, and I want to test myself against the best. He's got a belt at my weight. I've got a belt. Let's get it on. Let's unify.
Yeah, man. And do you think? I mean, obviously you like that in Manchester, wouldn't you? But did you see that? I mean, is one of your dreams to sort of fill a stadium like Man City Stadium or something like that?
Yeah, but I'm a mile off that. I mean, I didn't even nowhere near fill the MM, so small steps at a time. If I can double that next time what was there, I'd be more than happy. But yeah, if I could get that when I was fighting in Manchester, I think people would want to come watch it, because I think he's earned himself a lot of fans over here as well with his performances off against Crawler. So
yeah
it'd be a good fight for this. Yeah. Neutrals as well.
Do you think that's the hardest fight in the lightweight division for you?
They're all hard fights. I mean, a world level is, like I say, Easter, Garcia.
Yeah.
Tough fights. I mean, Lomachenko's talking of moving up and that's a potential fight, and he's seen as one of the best pound for pound. So yeah, there's no easy fights out there, but yeah, this is what I'm asking for, big fights. So yeah, if you want to be seen as the best, you got to fight the best, and yeah, any one of them. But Linares is probably the one I prefer because of what he's done to Collar. It shows that if I beat him, then I'm the best. That's what I want next. If them fights don't happen, and I'm looking to move up, try and fight at 10, get a world title fight at 10 stone. But yeah, first and foremost, well, unify the division before I move up.
Okay, and something interesting I wanted to ask you this for you know, since I've seen this, but you put a tweet out about the commentary team at Sky not mentioning your name during the Crawler and Linares fight, and it was surprising because they were discussing the lightweight setup in the lightweight division. They were in Manchester and they hadn't mentioned the WBO champ from Manchester. What did that make you feel like when your name wasn't even mentioned in that sort of discussion?
Somewhat too harsh, mate, to be honest. It's one of them things they don't want to mention me in case people start talking about me and my profile blows on the back of them. They just want to try and keep me quiet. They can't wait till I get beat so people show up talking about me. So. I'm not too asked. I just keep winning, keep doing my job, and Frank's doing his job now, and BT, and by pushing me and boosting my profile. So yeah, I'm happy with the way things are going. Never been one for shouting my mouth off calling people, but yeah, I mean, boxing speaks for itself.
Is there anything you just want to say to the people that came out to support you on the night? I mean, I could hear the chants all night. I mean, you've got a great fan base in terms of like the proper loyal fan base, aren't they? The loyal.
Yeah, of course. It's a dream come true to walk out in the MEN and Ricky Atteney went and watched her against Costa Zoo as a young boy. So yeah, for him to walk me out is like, makes the hair stand up on the back of my neck, went knowing that he's just calling my name, and the ring announcer shouting it. And undefeated lightweight champion in the world, best record in Britain. I feel like proper honoured, and yeah, it's for everyone who come out and support me. Yeah, just like, yeah, I'm grateful, and hopefully they all enjoyed it and had a good night and can get that big fight and then can come and watch me in that one.
And you've heard it here from the WBO lightweight champion of the world, Terry Turbo Flanagan. We're British boxers, you know the score. Power.